Welcome back. I hope you have enjoyed this course so far. But I don't really know what you think. So I want to ask you to give us some feedback on this course in an online feedback form that we have created. I will give you some more information at the end of this video. But first, let us talk about materials, because the topic of this week is material flow analysis. As a society, we all use heaps of materials all the time. Concrete and steel for buildings and infrastructure, fossil fuels for energy supply and plastic products, biomass for food production, metals like copper, aluminium, zinc, and many other metals for special products. Today, every person on the planet uses about 10 tons of materials every year. That means we extract more than 70 billion tons of materials from the natural environment every year and process them into products and ultimately into waste. As you can imagine, all this material consumption comes with enormous environmental impacts, such as land use and pollution from mining, greenhouse gas emissions from processing and transporting, and further pollution when the materials eventually become waste. In order to keep these impacts as low as possible, we need to manage our material consumption. And in order to do that, we first need to know when, where, and how many materials we use. This is exactly what material flow analysis does. Behind me, you can see some typical material flow diagrams. One of them is about concrete production in Australia. It tells us exactly how many of which resources we need to produce concrete. We can use this to work out how, for example, much Portland cement we can replace with fly ash or slag to produce low-carbon geopolymer concrete. Construction materials are a good example for material flow analysis, because you can clearly see the typical stages of the material cycle, such as extraction, transport, addition to stock, that is when we actually build a building, and recycling or waste, that is what happens after we demolish a building. But as you will see this week, material flow analysis can be applied to any material or any substance that you can think of. Other typical examples are phosphorus in the food system, for example, or pollutants in drinking water. Can you think of more examples? When the video stops now, please type in 3 examples for materials or substances for which you would like to do a material flow analysis. I will then pick out the most interesting ones and we can talk about it in class. I'm looking forward to seeing you in class. Before then, please do give us feedback on the course by taking that short survey under this week's topic box in Moodle. It will only take a few minutes, but it will be very useful for us to improve our teaching for the rest of the course. Thank you very much.